Well, in today's Money Monday, success tastes so sweet when we are achieving it, but we might be forgetting to dot the I's or cross the T's when we hit those milestones when they're happening. So we've got Kyle Winkfield of Finley Alexander here with some big news and, as always, some great wisdom. So, Kyle, let's just start right out. What is it?
So in a couple of weeks, I'm going to be a dad to a little boy. So now that makes me my three sons. So, so I'm excited, but you know, with my wife, she's like, "Hey, this is it. We're done." So we finally understand how other people feel when they say, "Any more kids?" No. We love her, you know, but it's just, you know.
Oh, this is so exciting! It's exciting for you. Three boys. You definitely do have to be a financial planner because they're going to eat you out of house and home as they grow up. So you've got three, and I know that sleep deprivation, when that hits, you know, parents, they really forget everything.
Yeah, they do. It can wear you out, and you can wonder, they say this is a blessing, but it feels like, so I think, you know, when that happens, you know, you definitely want to be alert and pay attention to some of the things that are going on in the background and take care of those as well.
Yes. Okay. So what should we be doing?
So I think whenever you hit a milestone, whether you get a new job, transition from a job, lose a job, get laid off, married, get a new life partner, whatever it is, new child, go back to all your financial documents, because for so many of us, it's out of sight, out of mind, set it and forget it. And that the problem is they set it under certain circumstances, those circumstances change and they forget about it. We want to make sure we're updating our beneficiaries. So go to your financial accounts, like your 401k or IRA or whatever, make sure those beneficiaries are consistent with the new milestone. The second piece is, do you have a will? Do you have a trust? Maybe you don't. Now this is a chance to be like, maybe I should get one. Okay, so now update that to make sure that what you want to happen will happen even though you're not here. And then we talk about all different things that take care of people you love. So like life insurance and making sure you, how much should you get? Do I have enough? Those kinds of things. And then if there's a kid like with me, what kind of savings are we putting aside for them for college and everything else? So reassessing and figuring out a new plan, because it's a new day.
I like that you said to do it around milestones, because I think a lot of times we miss those milestones. We don't think about it. I've got a birthday milestone coming up this year, and so of course I'm thinking about it. But I think a lot of times we sort of put these things off and we're like, yeah, maybe January I will, or maybe whatever, March I will. But it's not clockwork the way that we should be changing our batteries and our fire alarm when it's, you know, daylight savings.
Yeah, it isn't. And I think about milestones that happen every year for you. So birthday. So it might be one of those things where you just set a reminder in your phone or your calendar that says on your birthday, guess what you're going to do? You're also going to go look at all your financial accounts and all the other legal documents that you might have, and just make sure everything's the way you want it, because things have probably changed over that past year. The other piece for couples or life partners, when's your anniversary? So at the anniversary, sit down together. That could be a wonderful thing, because again, if you can get on the same page financially with your life partner, life is good. Even if you go through some tough times financially, life can still be good because you both got each other's back. But if you're not having those conversations as a couple, then what happens is, if you don't use milestones or make it a habit to check in and figure this out, you start to go like this, and nobody ever gets together with somebody and thinks, oh yeah, one day we're going to do this. You want to kind of do this. And we know that finances can be one of those pieces that if you don't pay attention, it's going to go like that. So get on the same page.
Very, very true.
Use your anniversary.
And I feel like a lot of people are finding themselves in that situation right now. If that is the case for some of our viewers, how can they reach out to you and get in touch with Finley Alexander?
Well, you just, finleyalexander.com. Just hit us up on the website. Check out some of the events we're having, both virtually. We do a lot of teaching, a lot of classes, workshops, webinars that you can sign up for on various financial topics.
Great. All right. Kyle Winkfield, thank you so much for being with us, and congratulations on baby boy number three. We got to hear all the details when he arrives, and we'll be right back with more Midday Maryland right after this. Stay tuned.